Dear students, today in this session we shall learn how to draw the different views for a tank sluice with head and gibbet valve. Before we actually proceed with the example number 1, we shall have a look at the model of the tank sluice with head and gibbet valve so that we will get some basic idea or the concept how exactly the structure is. So when we look at this particular model, this is the model of a tank sluice with head and gibbet valve. So it is a just portion of the bund in which the tank sluice has been constructed. So from this side, if you look, the cross section of the bund is clearly visible. This is the top width of the bund. That is the front slope or upstream side slope, water facing slope, and this is the downstream slope. So when you come to this side, on the upstream side, as we discussed or understood in our PPT presentation, there will be an inlet chamber. So this is the inlet chamber. These two are the wing walls, and this is the inside. That is the plug chamber. Here the white color one is a plug, and the plug can be opened to withdraw the water. So on the top, if you look, this one, these two are the gibbet walls. This is the head wall. So on the downstream side, there is a rear cistern here. So this is the top wall, this is the bottom side wall. There will be an opening through which the water flows, and the canal will be connected here. So these two sides walls will be sloping from top wall to the bottom side wall. If you look inside, how exactly the structure is, we are just trying to open here. So if you look here, this is the closed barrel through which the water flows. Here in this model, a rectangular barrel has been shown, or it is with a rectangular barrel. So if you just open here, so this will be the longitudinal section or the view. So here the wing wall will be visible in the elevation. So here the cut portion, this is nothing but the head wall, and behind this one the gibbet wall will be visible in the elevation, and these are the guide slabs. This is the plug chamber, and this is the plug, so it can be operated from the top. So this is nothing but your barrel. So this is nothing but your barrel with a RCC cover on the top. So this is actually the basic structure of a tank sluice. As we mentioned again, there will be an inlet chamber on the top, a rear cistern on the downstream side, and a barrel to connect the inlet chamber with the rear cistern. So now let us try to understand how to draw the different views for a given example of head wall and gibbet wall. So here the details of a tank sluice have been mentioned. This particular problem is available in the study material. This is example number 1. So he has mentioned the top width of the bund, he has given the front slope of the bund, rear slope of the bund, and he has given the different RLs, the RLs of top, the maximum water level, full tank level, and the sill level of the sluice. Then he has given the top width and of head wall as well as the gibbet wall. He has given the bottom width of the head wall. He has given the thickness of the concrete below head wall, gibbet wall, and the cistern. It is uniform and is mentioned as 0.5 meter. He has given the plug chamber size. Then he has mentioned the size of the rear cistern. This is the height of cistern wall. Next one, he has given the thickness of cistern wall, opening of the cistern, diameter of the plug hole he has mentioned. Then he has mentioned the dia of RCC barrel. So from this we will get understand that this particular tank sluice, the type of the barrel provided is a RCC circular barrel, since the dia is mentioned there. So for this particular example, we shall try to understand how to draw the different views. So to begin with first view, that is the longitudinal section of tank sluice, we need to first mention or mark all the given levels in the descending order. That is to start from the top one, RL of top of one. So we need to mark all the levels with the paint lines. To begin with the top, that is RL of top of the pond, it is 314 meters. So we will mention here RL of top equal to 314 meters. The next level is maximum water level, that is 313.5, so at a distance of 0.5 meter below the top. So this is MWL, maximum water level, 313.5 meters. The next is FTL, that is full tank level. It is given as 312.5 . So FTL is 312.5 meters. Next year is mentioned as the sill level of the sluice as 310. So from here it will be at a distance of 2.5 meters. So on the board I am going to just draw a representative drawing. It may not be possible for me to draw exactly to the scale. So whereas while drawing, you people are supposed to draw the same to the required scale. So this one is sill level. The value given is 310. So we have marked all the levels now. You should take a reference line here, or the center line on both sides of half the portion of the triangle. Okay. To begin, so let us now demarcate the details of bund first. So the bund details are given as top end 2 meters. So on either side 0.5 meter, 0.5, 1 meter, 1 meter. So this is 2 meters. So now we shall draw the upstream side slope. So how to draw the upstream side slope? He has given the front slope. Front slope is nothing but upstream side slope is mentioned as 1.5:1. So always one is vertical here in the slope, one will be vertical and one of the first value will be horizontal. So to begin here, you take 1 meter as a vertical and 1.5 meter as a horizontal. You will get a point, just join these two, you will get the paint line. You can draw later, you can make the same to the required darkness. This is the upstream side slope. In this same way, we can now draw the downstream side slope. The value given is 2:1. From here, you take 1 meter, that is vertical. Again, from here, you take 2 meter as horizontal. You will get a point. Join these two. You will get the, and draw a faint line. You will get the downstream side slope. Now we shall draw the details of head wall and gibbet wall. So the head wall will be positioned here at the maximum water level, above which there will be concrete layer. So first we shall draw here one line. So just now, as we had a look over the model, when we cut this particular tank sluice along the center of the barrel, we will be able to see the gibbet wall. In this, I have to accommodate the plug chamber dimension inside, and then the thickness of the side wall of the plug chamber. So plug chamber size is given as 0.6 meter into 0.6 meter into 0.45. So basically the plug chamber will be like this. So we will understand this one first separately, so that it will be easy for us to draw the views. Okay. So here there are three walls. This one we call it as a head wall. This is the head wall. These two are the gibbet walls. These two are the gibbet walls. These two gibbet walls and the head wall will be constructed monolithically, so that one inlet or the chamber is formed here in the middle. This is what we call it as a plug chamber. So here the plug chamber, the arrangement will be something like this. So there will be a barrier here, a shutter like thing or a wall, which will obstruct the entry of the water directly into the plug chamber. Whereas here a plug hole will be provided, so the water will be entering into this plug hole, then it will pass through this barrel and then it will enter into the rear system provided on the dungeon side, then it will be connected to the canal. So this is the basic one. So here again, to obstruct the entry of the bund material into the inlet chamber, on both the sides two wing walls will be constructed. So this is the plan, this is the top view what we can say, from which we will be able to understand the different components. So this is how the head wall, gibbet wall will be constructed to form the plug chamber. So from this, now what I am drawing here, I am drawing the longitudinal section. Where I have taken the section? I have taken the section through the center of the barrel. So this view, when I cut here, what are the things which will be visible to me, that I will be drawing here. So coming to this portion now, so what is this one? This is the gibbet wall. So this will be the length of the gibbet wall. So length of the gibbet wall will not be given directly, we need to assess from this detail. So what will be this dimension? This will be the dimension of plug chamber. So here plug chamber dimension is given as 0.6 meter this side and 0.6 meter in the other direction, and the third 0.45 will be the height that we are going to mark here. So 0.6 meter again, one barrier wall. So let us take this as 0.15. So totally it will be 0.75 meter. So that is 0.75 meter I have taken here. 0.75 meter from here. So this I have drawn, this portion I have drawn. So now here I have to draw the head wall. So what is the head wall dimension given? Head wall dimension is 0.5 meter at the top, 0.9 meter at the bottom. So I shall take a thickness of 0.5 meter at the top and 0.9 meter at the bottom. So we shall just join these two with a paint line. So now this is head wall. This is head wall. After this, we shall now incorporate the plug chamber. So as I mentioned, what is the dimension of the plug chamber? 0.6 into 0.6 into 0.45. when you cut here, you will be able to see only two dimension, one is 0.6, another is 0.45. so from here you measure 0.6 and take a height of 0.45, and your plug chamber is here. This will be your plug chamber. This is 0.6, this is 0.45. so now we shall provide the concrete above these. This is the concrete above the gibbet wall as well as the head wall. So here there will be a plug hole in the middle of 200 mm diameter, and there will be a plug. So this is your plug, right? So to operate this plug, one rod will be attached and it will be protruding little bit above the top of this concrete. The person who want to operate will be standing on this one and he will be operating with this rod. So to have a balance or to support this vertical rod, the guide slabs will be provided on both the sides. So at some spacing, say 1 meter center to center. So these are called as guide slabs for supporting this. Now I have taken these guide slabs at 1 meter center to center, and I kept the thickness as 0. From here you take 1 meter center, on either side you take 0.1 meter and 0.1 thickness, and on this side you can just take 0.2 and 0.2. So these are the guide slabs. So now this will be, this portion is visible in the elevation, so that also I will be drawing just two lines. Then here, now when we cut, this particular barrel, piped barrel will be visible in section. So where the pipe will be fixed? So the pipe will be fixed from here from the inlet chamber up to the from this plug chamber up to the rear system. So this is 0.45, 0.15 is the thickness of this wall. So now I am fixing here or drawing the barrel line. So what is the dimension of the barrel? It is 0.6 meter there. From here to here it is 0.6 meter, 0.45 plus 0.15. So this particular portion of the head wall will be not visible here, therefore I am taking it with a dotted line. So let us make this line as a dark. So this portion will be cut, therefore I am showing the stone masonry symbol. Generally it will be constructed with a masonry. So this completes the barrel portion. So I need to show here the thickness of the barrel also, because the new pipes will have small thickness. When you cut, the thickness is also visible. You can just show a small line here at the bottom also for the thickness. For the so whatever the portion which is remaining here, so this will be the portion of ring wall. This is the portion of ring wall. So ring wall will be having a slope. So we will just try to indicate the slope by gradually closing lines. So this indicates the direction of the slope. So we shall take this energy dark now. So we have completed the portion of divot wall, head wall, plug chamber, the plug arrangement, wing wall and the barrel. Now we need to draw the rear system here, where exactly the barrel is going to intersect with the downstream slope. We need to mention or we need to draw the chamber here. So the inlet, the rear system has got four walls. This is the top side wall, downside wall and the two side walls. When you the structure, the section will be like this. Below there will be a concrete bed. So this is downstream side wall, this is the upstream side wall, and the side walls will be connecting the upstream wall and the downside wall, upside wall and downside wall. So this dimension is given as 1 meter. He has given height of system wall 1 meter, and he has given thickness of the system wall is 0.5 meter. Since it is given only 0.5 meter, we shall assume the top and bottom thickness are same. So this we are going to draw here. So what we need to draw first? From here we have to measure 1 meter from the bottom. So this is already 0.6 and above is 0.4 meter. So when we cut here, this wall will be cut. Therefore, I am drawing a dotted line here. So next we will take 0.5 as the thickness. So this is your top wall. So then what will be visible? This is the length of or inside dimension of the inlet chamber along the x direction. What is the dimension given here? Cistern dimension has to give. So if he has not given the cistern dimension, so he has given it. Size of the rear cistern is 1.5 meter by 1.5 meter. So in both the direction it is 1.5 meter. So here, from here I am taking a measurement of 1.5 meter, then I will be showing the downstream side wall. So what is the dimension of downstream? It is 0.5 and 0.6 meter. Then I shall show a sloping line which indicates the side wall. So this wall will be cut, therefore I am showing a cross sectional symbol. So this completes the rear system. So what we need to show here? We have to show the thickness of the concrete. So thickness of the concrete below head wall, divot wall and cistern, for all is given as 0.5 meter. So generally we are going to put the bed concrete with an offset always. Okay, so I shall take a 0.25 or 0.3 meter offset here. Since it is not mentioned anything, you can assume the value suitably. I am drawing a 0.5 thickness line here. So I am taking an offset here also. So this is your bed concrete. So now we shall make this line dark. So whatever the portion here, you can either draw with a dotted line or you can leave as it is. So this completes your longitudinal section of the tank sleeves. So now we shall make the detailing here. So detailing shall be made with 45 degree line. So first we shall mention the slopes here. This is 2:1 on the downstream side, and it is 1.5:1 on the upstream side. Okay. So then we shall mention here the top width of head wall, and here the bottom width of the head wall is 0.9 meter, and we can show here the plug chamber dimension. It is 0.6 meter, and this dimension is 0.15 meter, and this is the 0.6 meter dia RCC barrel, and this dimension we can show it as 1.5 meter, and this is 0.6 meter, and this thickness of the concrete 0.5 meter. So this completes the longitudinal section LS of tank sleeves. To brief again, first we need to take all the levels in the decreasing order, to begin with the top to end with the sill. Once we draw that levels with the faint lines, take a center line, the portion of the drawing will be half on this side and half on the other side. Then after drawing this one, try to draw the section of the bund first with the faint line. Once you complete that one, you start drawing the length of the gibbet wall, which will not be directly given. We need to assess it from the dimension of plug chamber as well as the thickness of this barrier wall. Once you draw this, then you demarcate the section of the head wall. Since it is cut, here the top and bottom width will be visible. So the top is 0.5 and bottom is 0.9. Draw a faint line, and then you demarcate this plug chamber. After that, show the barrel. Once you show the barrel, finish this one. You show the plug. Then these are the guide slabs for supporting the rod, which is connected to the plug for the opening and closing. Then you show the wing wall. Then you complete the rear system and show the grid. Only this portion will be cut here. Sorry, so this portion will not be cut here. Only the top portion will be cut. So you just show the dotted line. Only dotted line can be shown, because here the barrel will be continuing up to this face. Okay. On either side of the barrel, there will be wall. So what will happen here? If you can understand this from the plan, the RCC barrel will be continued up to the inside face of this rear system. When you exactly cut here, only this portion, the topmost portion, will be in section. Therefore, you have to show the measurement symbol only for this topmost portion, whereas this shall be shown with a dotted line. So this completes your longitudinal section of tank sleeves. So in the next session of our video, we shall learn how to draw the half plan at top and half plan at bottom for this particular question or the problem. Thank you.